Let's discuss on the rate equation for first order reactions. The reaction in which the overall rate of the reaction is proposed to the or proportional to the first power of the concentration of one of the reactants is called as first order reaction. Consider the reaction A which gives the product with the constant K1. So rate of the reaction is equal to minus d of A divided by dt into K1 into A power 1.0, where K1 is the rate constant of the first order reaction. At the beginning of the reaction, time t is equal to 0. Let the concentration of A be A mole per liter. After the reaction has processed for some time t, let the concentration of A that has reacted be x mole per liter. The concentration of unreacted A remaining at time t will be A minus x mole per liter. The rate of the reaction will be dx divided by dt for a first order reaction. And here is the equation. The rate is given by dx divided by dt is equal to k1 into A minus x. So integrating on both the side, you will be getting dx divided by A minus x is equal to k1 into integration of dt. You will be getting minus of log A minus x equal to k1 into t plus c. Where t is equal to 0 and x equal to 0, in the above equation, you got c is equal to minus log of A. So this is the rate equation for the first order reaction. So, substituting the value of a C in the above equation minus log of A, we'll be getting this one. So, K1 is equal to 1 by T log of A divided by A minus X, which is K1 is equal to 2.303 by T log A by A minus X. The unit of K1 is given is per second. This equation is called a first order rate constant equation. I got a small beaker with a solution of copper chloride in concentrated hydrochloric acid. With this one, I tried to make a small solution. You are able to see there is a small agitation happening inside the beaker, which enables the rotation. Now I am trying to put some aluminium foil in it. Got more aluminium foil. Aluminium reacts with the hydrochloric acid and it produces hydrogen gas. You are able to see the hydrogen gases start coming out. Once if I try to burn it, you are able to see a permanent flame of flame is created. So aluminium with H2O will give aluminium and water and hydrogen. This is how your flame is created. The color of flame is blue and green color due to the presence of copper 2 plus ions. So we got the experimental data of A and A minus X at different periods of time t. You got A minus X1 and A minus X2. At t1, difference in t2 minus t1. But x1 and x2 are the amounts are reacted in t1 and t2 periods of time. And this is the equation. You got it?